This is Matt Marzillo from Snowflake talking about how to unlock AI insights for all users with agents and copilots. Y'all give it up. Give it up. Come on.
Thanks, Burke. So hello, I am Matt Marzillo. So quick introduction. I am a partner sales engineer, solution engineer at Snowflake. I've been here for about 3 years. I spend most of my time working with customers and helping them understand how to use Microsoft and Snowflake together. So I checked yesterday. I think this calendar year alone, I've had 86 unique contacts with customers. So I guess that's a little bit of my credibility. I do work directly with customers, help them everything from kind of understand what I'm presenting today to also hands-on keyboard, helping them work through problems and getting connected. Previously worked at Microsoft. We have a whole team here at Snowflake. Also a corollary team at Microsoft to help support the partnership. I'm dedicated to helping customers understand how to use our platforms together and also motivate our product to build integrations. So really quick, I'm going to do a high level on our partnership and then talk specifically about the generative AI integrations we have, and then I have a demo video to show y'all. So really quick, that sort of pie architecture in the middle, that's Snowflake. 13 years ago, Snowflake was created. We were prominently a data warehouse natively built for the cloud, right? So if you're used to that traditional data warehouse experience, our founders are from Oracle, you had it. And they had all the great scalability and easy use associated with the cloud. Since then, we've grown, right? We are a true developer platform for developing things, applications with your data, all data-centric development. But around that, we have integrations with a lot of widely adopted Microsoft tools, right? So Power BI, the data platform, different AI and ML tools like Azure ML and AI Foundry, OpenAI, Entra ID, Purview, and what have you. You can tell from what I'm saying, like there's obviously a little bit of overlap between what Snowflake offers and what some Microsoft services offer, but we have ways to make sure customers can easily integrate where we see that they need to. Not Gen AI, but worth talking is that you can hear when I'm describing Snowflake, it does sound a bit like Fabric. That said, we do have a great integration with Fabric. So if you're interested in talking more detail, we have a booth here. But we do have a way of using Snowflake with Fabric. It's leveraging an Iceberg and Delta catalog connector that does some translation. And the whole idea is that you can have one replication of your data and be able to easily use Snowflake compute and services alongside Fabric compute and services. All right, enough about boring Iceberg open table format stuff. Let's talk about generative AI. So really quick, like high level, you know, Microsoft obviously has a lot of generative AI capabilities. It starts in the middle there with, you know, Azure OpenAI, and then you have Copilot experience for building chatbots and applications. You also have AI Foundry to host a model catalog and do all of your pro code development of agents. So Snowflake has different versions of this. Because we're a true SaaS platform, we don't necessarily have separate services, but we have a suite of features and functionality that allow you to do generative AI in Snowflake. Anything that does Gen AI in Snowflake is called Cortex, right? So Cortex is the word here. If you kind of look at it as far as like three layers, you know, foundationally, we have a model garden, right? So we have a lot of widely used models. We have the OpenAI models, the Anthropic models, Llama models, as well as some others. And then on top of that, we have the ability or the functionality to do things with those models with your data, right? So simply put, we have these task-specific SQL functions, right? So it's as simple as one of your pipelines, you just want to do a summarize this data with this model and produce an output. You can just bake that right in your pipeline or classify it or translate it, really easy. And then we also have Cortex Analyst and Cortex Search. So Cortex Search is a search service, right? So you have some unstructured data sitting in a stage in Snowflake, and then you can create a Cortex Search service very easily, which then exposes a REST API endpoint that you can use either internally in Snowflake for app development or externally. We have Cortex Analyst, which is a different architecture, but it's basically text to highly accurate SQL with your structured data, right? So with Analyst and Search together, what you can then do is lay a Cortex data agent on top of it. And then you can use that agent to plain text query it, and it will decide whether or not to go to a variety of different analyst services or a variety of different search services, so you can ask questions of all of your data and know you're getting the right answer. So, I'm kind of sidebar here. I really think the experience in Snowflake of like doing Gen AI stuff with your data is like best in market right now. We've done a really good job of building out these tools.
It's like
get bothered for an update. We've done a really good job of building out these tools, and they're really easy to use. And also, it's all kind of bounded by the Snowflake security RBAC control posture. Then on top of that, we have a studio experience, we have observability, we have a Copilot experience inside of Snowflake, as well as document AI for extracting information from scanned documents. So in saying all that, right, there's overlap between what Microsoft has and what Cortex has. But what we're seeing is that primarily there's two ways or two different flavors of the ways that customers are integrating Microsoft and Snowflake for generative AI. So the first flavor is, so I mentioned that we have Azure OpenAI hosted in Snowflake, right? But we also have customers who have their own OpenAI service, right? Whether it's they have a better deal, they're a large enterprise, they negotiated a big contract with Azure OpenAI, or they built some custom stuff. It's really easy to securely connect to Azure OpenAI from Snowflake or any other external service for that matter. It's something called Snowpark External Access, a great name, but you really easily create an external object, supports private link, and you just kind of authenticate into whatever service you want to. That said, we also have Azure OpenAI inside of Snowflake, right? So all deployed on Azure. You don't have to manage a separate service or manage a separate relationship. You just pay Snowflake for whatever token usage you have with that Azure OpenAI model, and you can use those models from right inside of Snowflake. So this is sort of kind of, hey, I want to develop inside of Snowflake, whether it's a pipeline, maybe it's a Streamlit app inside of Snowflake, and I want to connect to some external services for GenAI at Microsoft. Either would use it this way or this way. There's a little bit of flexibility for how you can use those services. Now, the other side of it, right, is let's say you develop a data agent or some sort of GenAI service on your Snowflake data. And yes, you can build a chatbot inside of Snowflake. We have something called Streamlit that allows you to do that. But what we're hearing from customers is like, you know, I don't want to have six different, you know, chatbot experiences that my users need to use. I want to have one unified experience. And Copilot's becoming a really kind of popular place for that. So what you can do today, right, and this is all powered by our Power Automate integration that we already have, is you can build a Cortex Analyst service inside of Snowflake on your structured data. You can build a Cortex Search service inside of your unstructured data in Snowflake, and then wrap that Cortex agent around the top of it and easily connect to it from Copilot along with any other services or agents you might want to connect to. We have Quick Start that show you how to do this. You configure OAuth with Microsoft Graph through Entra ID. So anytime you user enters that tenant, they are now using the role as defined in that tenant with Snowflake. So what that looks like, and I added this last minute because I realized I was presenting a deck with absolutely no code at all. So I just want to show a little bit of code at build. On the left side, building a Cortex search object in or service inside of Snowflake is just that easy. As soon as you create that search service, it automatically creates the API endpoint, and you can access that from wherever. Cortex Analyst, similarly, and the reason why it's so accurate is that you do have to create a semantic file for your structured data. We have ways of automating the creation of that semantic file, but it often needs a little bit of a human in the loop to map business definitions to data definitions. And once you create that semantic file inside Snowflake, it will also expose that endpoint. So I talked about you develop those two services, you create an agent, and then you can manually connect Copilot to that agent. But we're rolling out a new integration, right, where as soon as you create this Cortex agent, right, laid on top of Cortex Search and Cortex Analyst, and then you configure OAuth from a Microsoft tenant to Snowflake, there will be the ability to automatically just use that Cortex agent from any 365 Copilot experience, notably Teams. So the only two things you have to do is create the agent inside of Snowflake and then set up and configure the OAuth to securely connect to Snowflake. This is going to be generally available in limited regions come June. So look, we have our big conference summit is the first week of June in San Francisco. So look for more announcements about this around that time. And then this is what the experience will look like. So let's say that you're a product manager and you have a new feature that isn't performing as well as you would like to, and that you know that you have some structured and some unstructured data or just a lot of data on that feature and on the usage of that feature inside of Snowflake. You can come into Teams Copilot here. There will be a Cortex Agent application that you open with the UI. And under the hood here, you've already built the Cortex Analyst service, the Cortex Search service, and then laid that Cortex Agent on top of it, which uses an LLM to kind of broker those decisions. And as long as that's created and you have that OAuth configured, you can just type your question in here, ask, you know, what are the adoption rates for last quarter? And then can you cross-reference them with any interview notes with customers, right? So referencing some of that unstructured data that's available in Snowflake. So right now it's reaching into Snowflake, it's using that agent, it's accessing those services that need to be asked, and then synthesizing an answer that could then be spit out to the user. And it says here, yeah, it looks like there were low rates. And there were some interviews criticizing the onboarding flow. So now, if you're, you discover this as a product leader, you're going to go to your devs and you're going to blame them and say, hey, your rusty onboarding flow for feature A is causing low adoption rates. Let's get it fixed. So all right from that same experience, the product leader is able to identify the problem, solve it, and or not solve it, but then pass it along to the people to solve it. So that's it. Thank you. We do have a large booth here. It's booth 305. If you kind of look over to your right, it's through there. You can go ahead and provide us some feedback if you'd like to. One thing I recommend to folks who aren't familiar with Snowflake, there's a free 30-day trial. Go to quickstarts.snowflake.com. There's a lot of great resources for getting started with just basic Snowflake and then also connecting Snowflake with different Microsoft services. Thanks a lot.